Once upon a time, during his vacation, Yannick Lightspeed Kilcher found chai. He had so much of chai and he liked it so much that he turned into the host of Chai Time Data Science. That's why I'm hosting Machine Learning News. Hi everyone, I'm Sayyam. I host the Chai Time Data Science podcast, also YouTube channel. And I'm hosting Machine Learning News today because I'm holding the mic. Yes. Before we start the news, I have a news to Meta. I don't care, I'm holding the mic. I'll be interviewing Yannick on my channel, linked in the description. If you have any questions that you want me to ask him, any questions that you want to ask him and you want me to ask him so that your questions can be asked to him, you get the point. Please leave a comment down below. I'll make sure I ask you questions to Yannick. And now let's start with your weekly, absolutely regular. You don't need to look at your calendar. You know it's mundane. In this week's news, Amazon's new game breaks a few. Actually, quite a lot. 3090s. Imagine running a game and breaking your GPUs. OpenAI pivots from robots. They take a pivot away from that direction. And Google, interesting timing, launches a new company to build software for industrial robots. Welcome to Machine Learning News. Before we start, I have something important. It's hot, but it's really good. So this is Kashmiri Kahwa. I recommend it. I recommend any chai. Let's jump into it. Amazon's new MMO may be breaking NVIDIA 3090s, the Verge writes. After intensive Googling, we have discovered that MMOs are massively multiplayer online games. Amazon created this massively multiplayer online game. See, now I know. Apparently, this was breaking a few EVGA cards. Since then, the game has been patched and Amazon's issued a statement that is there in this blog. But based on what I've understood by watching so many YouTube videos, the power draw on these graphic cards was just going haywire when the game would launch, and that would end up frying the card, which is kind of crazy. I mean, I'm not supposed to laugh at these. These are like pretty expensive cards, but it's kind of crazy to think that a game could do that and that these cards could go through that. Luckily, EVGA has like phenomenal customer service. Based on what I understand, when you return a product, the RMA process is undertaken. Now, GPUs are pretty short on supply, but EVGA has a separate supply of cards for just covering under warranty, and they've already started shipping out cards. Kudos to these guys, but how is that under machine learning news? Well, if you're in machine learning, you probably would want a 3090 and you wouldn't want a game to break it. OpenAI, check Yannick's previous video here for an intro about it. OpenAI pivots from robotics and acknowledges the power of simulation, VentureBeat, right? So OpenAI co-founder, I don't want to butcher their name, W. Zarambia, has shared, according to this blog, that the company is pivoting from solving robotics. Robotics is such a harder problem. I feel it's quite underrated and we're still working on this, even though we have somewhat cars that can drive themselves. In the US, in India, you can't, at least where I'm from. I mean, these cars work well when they do, but then they don't, because so many real world constraints kick in. And that's again something that robotics deals with as a challenge. So that's what they talk about in this blog. And it appears that OpenAI will be focusing on other problems. Interesting timing on this. But Google's parent company Alphabet launches Intrinsic, new company to build software for industrial robots, The Verge writes. After reading this and reading the original post, the announcement post by Wendy Tan White, who will be leading this company, what I've understood is a large part. Chai is still hot. Chai is still pretty hot. A large part of manufacturing is based on robotics and a large number of industries need this. Now, personally, I'm not sure. So like for computers, the nice thing is you have x64 architectures for phones. You have ARM architectures for iOS. Can't do anything, but there are different architectures. I mean, iOS does have the developer kit, but I'm not sure if the industry has standard robots. So I'm sure like they would be a similar type of robots on an assembly line. Intrinsic will be developing software for those robots. Who their customers are isn't clear from the blog. That's one thing that The Verge mentioned as well. But it's interesting to see that robotics is making some progress in different areas, and we're just starting to understand how difficult a problem this is. I mean, I've seen Boston Dynamics Robots Dance, which is really, really cool. And it's great to see more companies working in this direction. Forbes writes, AI is learning to understand how vegetables taste. I won't believe in the internet until I can download food. These things don't surprise me. So you can actually 3D print food, which means that I believe in the internet. Sorry. This blog talks about a farm called Fifth Season, which is in Pittsburgh, that is using a software stack and robotics to automate their farms. And what they're trying to understand is, based on this blog, what I've understood, they have QR codes associated with different plants, and they really use data monitoring and really try to target a crop towards a certain taste, which is pretty good. I feel, again, in agriculture, it's again, so many areas where AI is just being applied, where machine learning just needs to be applied, and it'll become global. You know, we need TensorFlows for agriculture. We need PyTorches for agriculture, just like we need them for robotics. So it's great to see that this company is working for it. It's not open source, but at least there's some news around someone working on this. NASA writes, AI helps improve NASA's eyes on the sun. So NASA has been collecting images of the sun. You can take your phone, take a picture of the sun, but that's not good enough because you can't see UV rays from Earth since the atmosphere filters it out. You can't see UV rays anyways, and you wouldn't want to because they might damage your skin and eyes. But that is part of the spectrum that the sun emits, among many other things. So the sun isn't exactly how we see it from this Earth surface. NASA has been collecting these images over years now, and this blog talks about how they're trying to calibrate it. There's a nice animation that shows you how the calibration actually changes the images that we have. So based on robots that NASA has been sending into the orbit, now they're calibrating these images. Very cool. Next up, a man actually Black Mirror had foreshadowed this, and it's reality, sort of a reality now. A man used AI to bring back his deceased fiance. The creators of Tech warn it could be dangerous. I'm not going to get into how ethically right or wrong this is. That's an independent discussion, and that's why we need those discussions. But this blog talks about how this person, I'm not going to name the service, used a service built on top of GPT-3, which now makes sense that wasn't released, but is an API. So the person used the API and built a chatbot service on top of it. And this person, the one who contacted his deceased fiance, created a chatbot around it and just interacted with it for so long. I leave it at that and let you think about this. I'm not going to. This is a sensitive topic, so I don't want to speak too much about it. As if the robots were upset about OpenAI shutting down its robotics division, they collided at Ocado warehouse near London, sparking a fire and delaying orders, the Verge writes. If you're watching this, robots, I'm on the side of you. I'm on the side of Yannick. I know he's a robot. That's why he wears aviators to hide his vision system. Just wanted to tell you, I'm on your side. Jokes aside, again, a large part of these systems are being automated, and we really need companies working on these because, again, these problems happen and they can cause huge issues or damages. This wasn't a huge one, but again, that's why you need them. Too much ethics, but I feel these discussions are important. Reading Race, that's the name of the paper. AI recognizes patients' racial identity in medical images. Medical domain is one of those areas where the impact to humans is more directly felt than any other. That's when we talk about having biases in these models. This paper shows that these models are able to pick on the race of a person based on the medical images. Note, the doctor can't even make out from these pictures, these X-ray images, these CT scans, the race of a person. It's not because of just some tissue being fired for certain races, etc., etc., etc. That's what this paper says, and apparently it's also able to deduce these technologies. Deep learning algorithms are able to deduct based on corrupt images also the race of a person. They actually go ahead and show this in the studies as well. Let's say there's a race, chai race. I really like that, but there's also a coffee race. As a doctor, I can't imagine myself as a doctor, but let's picture myself as being a doctor. I might not give the best treatment to coffee. That's why we need more rigorous testing around these systems, and it's great to have such papers come up from now and then. DeepMind had created Alpha Fold 2. I'm sure Yannick would cover that paper on his channel. So AlphaFold 2 is an architecture based on transformers, and it has created this breakthrough in understanding protein folding and protein structures. That's an independent discussion, but it's a huge breakthrough in human history. And they've created this database of so many proteins that can be just very useful in understanding life and for biology. They've open sourced it. That's how research should be. And it's available for free as long as you cite the results for you to use. Very nice. ICCV launches Behavior Challenge. The goal of embodied AI research, as written in this post, is to develop intelligent agents that can assist humans in their everyday lives in activities like washing dishes, cleaning floors. Recent activities, like whatever progress you've seen, even the papers that Yannick discusses heavily, are narrow AIs, and these are slightly getting broader. But we need now further broader AI, if that makes sense. I'm not talking about AGI. It's broader AI. And these challenges, these tasks are a goal towards these. So there are different tasks that are a part of this. And the deadline is October 17th. I encourage you to check it out. The Behavior Challenge is a benchmark with 100 household activities that represent a new challenge. Very cool. And I look forward to seeing the results from this. IBM, MIT, and Harvard release Common Sense AI dataset at ICML. The argument in this post by IBM is when you see an infant, they're able to deduce so much just based on common sense, even at a young AI models can't. They've put together a lot of animations and similar things for an agent to learn these, along with few interesting baseline models. And they're trying to advance machine common sense. That's such a funny word. That's why I brought this up. Finally, Google AI generates even higher quality images. So generative adversarial networks. I mentioned this on my Twitter, but I'm also highly interested in these. That's why I got this nice box that you don't see. It's full of RGB. You know what I'm talking about. I feel this is an interesting area because we've seen so much progress recently. StyleGAN came out, which made the images super nice. Now we've seen a further improvement. I feel we really need a good benchmark to measure these beyond a certain point. But anyways, the team at Google released a new natural image synthesis super resolution via repeated refinements SR3 model and cascaded diffusion model. Based on the demo on the page, these images do look really nice quality. How nicer are they are compared to StyleGAN or the recent papers? You really need to look at them side by side. But what they say here is it can perform face super resolution in quite higher resolution. That's it. That's just an area I'm interested in. So I thought I might share that. But that is it for this week's machine learning news. You know, it's Monday. Thanks for tuning in on a Monday. Please subscribe to Yannick's channel. Let's get him to 100K so that we can celebrate his 100K subscribers on my interview. Leave a comment down below for the questions that you'd want me to ask him. For now, please keep drinking chai, please enjoying your day, and please keep watching ML News. Thanks for watching.